Hi everyone! Welcome to my channel, Tutorial by SiRymon. My name is Mr. Jem Raymond Chen, Master Teacher 2 from Escalante Central Elementary School, Schools Division of Escalante City, DepEd Region 6, Western Visayas. Click like and share if this video tutorial helps you. Don't forget to click subscribe below to keep updated for my future tutorial. For your suggestions, especially on the topic for my next tutorial, please leave your comment below. Hope you learned something in my video lessons for this week. Thank you so much for watching. Stay home and stay safe. Go forth, rise and shine to us all. Escalante Central Elementary School. You've entrusted us your vision. Building your dreams would be our mission. Amazing day, Grade 6! How are you today? I hope everybody is fine and safe. We are now on our Week 7 for Quarter 2 in Science 6 for this school year 2020-2021. We are now on the last 2 weeks for this quarter. Okay, what will we do for this week? Please take note of this. We will check first your summative test. Your summative test you took last week. The third summative test in Science 6. And after checking, we will check also your assessment about the ecosystem, the tropical rainforest, coral reefs, and mangrove swamps. And after checking your assessment for Module 6, we will discuss the Module 7, Protection and Conservation of Ecosystem. You know what, class? This is the last module for quarter 2 for this school year. Yes, last na lang tani nga lesson, class, kaysa sunod semana, mag-summative test na lang kita. Again, kining module 7, class, mauni siya ang last nga module sa quarter 2 for science 6. Please get now your notebook in science. I told you last time to copy your answers in your summative test and your assessment. Do it now. Okay, let us now check your summative test last week. Ready? Okay, let's have number 1. How will you describe invertebrate animals? A. They have backbones. B. They don't have backbones. C. All can walk and run fast. Or letter D. None of this. What's your answer? The correct answer is, obviously, it's letter B. Invertebrate animals don't have backbones. Number 2. The following are groups of organisms without backbone, except A. Arthropods. B. Mollusks. C. Echinoderms. Letter D. Osteichthyes. What's the correct answer? The correct answer is letter B, mollusks. Mollusks don't have backbone because mollusks is under invertebrate animals. Number 3. Which group of animals is not invertebrates? A. Group 1. B. Group 2. C. Group 3. Or letter D. Group 4. So we are looking for vertebrate because, as stated here in number 3, not invertebrate. So we are looking for vertebrate animals. And they are letter D. Group 4, we have the frogs, snakes, and dolphins are not invertebrates. But they are vertebrate animals. Number 4, refer to this chart below. Now as you see, again, you have to analyze before you answer number 4. Okay? Number 1 there. Have segmented bodies and top skeleton. The movement is crawl and fly. Group 2 are soft-bodied animals with shells, and they can swim and crawl. Number 3 there, have water vascular system, tube feet, and radial symmetry as adults. That they can swim. Number 4, they have one body opening and most have two-layer cell, and they can swim and float. And number 5, are flattened, elongated, worm-like animals, and their movement is crawled. So let's answer number 4. Invertebrates are classified into subgroups as shown in the chart. To which group do jellyfish and snails belong? A. They belong to group 4. B. They belong to group 5. Letter C. Jellyfish belong to group 4. And snails belong to group 2. Letter D. Jellyfish belong to group 1 while snails belong to group 3. What do you think is the correct answer? Yes, it's letter C. Jellyfish belong to group 4. They have one body opening and most have two layer cells. While snails belong to group 2. Snails belong to soft-bodied animals with shells. Number 5. Which group list of animals are all invertebrates? A. Snail, clams, squids. B. Snake, monkey, goat, and pig. C. Salamander, goat, pig, and frog. So letter D. Snake, turtle, lizard, and crocodile. The correct answer is letter A. The snail, the clams, and squids are all invertebrate animals. Letter B, letter C, and letter D are vertebrates. Number 6. They are the largest group in the animal kingdom. What group are they? A. Insects, B. Mammals, C. Cnidarians, or letter D. Sponges. Sila ang pinakadaghan sa animal kingdom. They are insects. Number 7. Refer to the animals inside the box. Which animals are molluscs? A. Crab and spider, they have segmented bodies. B. Snail and squid, they have soft-bodied animals with shells inside or outside. C. Sea stars and sea urchins, they have water vascular system. Or letter D. Sponges, they are pore-bearing animals. The correct answer is letter B. Snail and squid are molluscs, they have soft-bodied animals with shells inside or outside. Number 8. Which of the following belongs to worms? A. Flukes, B. Spider, C. Bee, or letter D. Mosquito. The correct answer is, of course, the letter A. Flukes. Number 9. Which among animals are arthropods? A. 1, 2, 4, B. 1, 2, 3, C. 2, 3, 4, or letter D. 3, 5, and 6. The correct answer is letter C, 2, 3, and 4. They are arthropods. Number 10. Which among animals are cnidarians? A, 1 and 5, B, 2 and 3, C, 3 and 4, or letter D, 4 and 5. The correct answer is 1 and 5. Number 11. Earthworms, leeches, and lugworms belong to which group of animals? A. Arthropods, B. Annelids, C. Platyhelminthes, or letter D. Nematodes. Worms belong to annelids. Letter B. Number 12. What of these groups of animals are examples of worms? A. Butterfly, fish, birds, B. Snake, turtle, lizard, C. Flukes, tapeworms, leeches, or letter D. Crab, millipede, and centipede. The correct answer is letter C. Fluke, tapeworms, and leeches are examples of worms. 13. Which of the following list are all the insects? A. Ants, bees, beetle, B. Crab, snake, turtle, C. Earthworm, centipede, millipede, or letter D. Tilapia, mudfish, and lizard. The correct answer for number 13 is letter A. Ants, bees, and beetle. 14. I have a soft body, a hard shell, and live on land and water. What am I? A. Mollusk, B. Arthropod, C. Echinoderm, or letter D. Cnidarian. That's mollusks. Number 15. I am an arachnid, have 4 pairs of legs, and a body with 2 sections. A. Echinoderm, B. Arthropod, C. Annelid, or letter D. Porifera. The correct answer is arthropod. 16. what program that Escalante Central Elementary School support and implement to help get rid of worms that enter or live inside the human body, especially for school children? A. Bantay Kalikasan. B. Bantay Bata. C. Deworming Program. Or letter D. Fagging. Actually, this program was implemented during our face-to-face classes. Yes, that's deworming program. Letter C. 17. Jellyfishes have powerful tentacles. What are their tentacles for? A. For excretion. B. For reproduction. C. For digestion. Or letter D. For capturing food and defense. The correct answer is letter D. For capturing food and defense. Number 18. How will you protect animals? A. Don't overkill fish like dynamite fishing. B. Support reforestation so that animals have their own habitat. C. Make money by killing and catching endangered animals in the forest. Or letter D. None of this is correct. Actually, we have two answers for this question. So, pwede rin mo answer ang duha or pwede usara. So, the correct answers are letter B and letter A. Don't overkill the fish and support reforestation. 19. Which describes the characteristics of sponges? A. They are pore-bearing animals. B. They have segmented bodies. C. They have shells. Or letter D. They have 8 legs. Sponges have 4 bodies. Or they are pore-bearing animals. 20. Which of these are crustaceans? A. Centipede, millipede. B. Beetle, B. Termite. C. Shrimps, crab, lobsters. Or letter D. Mite, ticks, and scorpions. The correct answer is letter C. Shrimp, crabs, and lobster. 21. Which is not a group of invertebrate animals? Which of these is not an invertebrate animal? Of course, that's letter D. Bird. 22. Spiders are examples of arthropods. C. 23. Segmented worms include? Correct. Letter A. Earthworm. 24. Which is cnidarian? A. Corals. B. Jellyfish. C. Anemones. Or D. All of these are correct. Of course, all these are correct. Corals, jellyfish, sea anemones are examples of cnidarian. 25. Leeches and flukes belong to what group of invertebrate animals? A. Crustacean. B. Worms. C. Cnidarian. Or letter D. Sponges. Answer is letter B. Count your score. What's your score? I hope you got a very good score on this summative test. A reminder lang ha, sa imuang ikatulo na ning output. Okay? So prepare another album, nagigad nga album about to sa invertebrate. This time, please prepare a compilation of pictures of invertebrate animals and then classify them and describe their distinguishing characteristics. Pwede print, pwede drawing, pwede clip, or pwede mga old newspaper na mga pictures sa mga animals or magazine. And compile this in a short size folder. Okay, this time, we will check your assessment you took last week. This could be found on page 19 on your module 6. Are you ready? Naaragya po ni sa inyong notebook ang answer ninyo ani. I hope you've copied your answers last week no in your assessment. Naara na sa inyong notebook kung inyong gikopya. Okay? So we will check your assessment now. Number 1. Which group of organisms can be found in the mangrove ecosystem? A. Mussels, fish, corals. B. Worm, rat, fish. C. Butterfly, snake, bird. D. Mangrove trees, fiddler crab, or fish. What's the answer? Correct. Letter D. Mangrove trees, fiddler crab, and fish. Number 2. What are the things needed by plants to make their own food? A. Water, chemicals, and oxygen. B. Oxygen and carbon dioxide. C. Oxygen and chemicals. Letter D. Carbon dioxide, soil, and sunlight. The correct answer is letter D. Carbon dioxide, soil, and sunlight are needed by plants to make their own food. Number 3. Which of the following describes a canopy of rainforest? A. Composed of trees that are 130 to 180 feet tall. B, about 59 feet and consists of trunk of canopy, shrubs, small plants, and trees. C, consists mostly of fungi, insects, worms, and litter from taller trees. Letter D, has slender trees from a dense platform of vegetation with 60 to 129 feet. The correct answer is letter D, has slender trees from a dense platform of vegetation with 60 to 129 feet. Number 4. What kind of interaction is shown when one organism kills another organism for food? A. Mutualism, B. Commensalism, C. Parasitism, or letter D. Predation. The correct answer is letter D. Predation. 5. It is an environment where both living and non-living things exist and interact with one another. A. Ecology, B. Ecosystem, C. Community, or letter D. Population. The correct answer is letter D. Ecosystem. Number 6. One example of competition in tropical rainforests is when the shrubs and trees are growing together in one area. What do they compete for? A. Sunlight and soil nutrients, B. Oxygen and carbon dioxide, C. Chemicals and oxygen, or letter D. Water and chemicals. The correct answer is letter A. Sunlight and soil nutrients. Number 7. Blank results from the interconnected food chains. A. Consumer, B. Producer, C. Food web, or letter D. Biotic component. The answer is letter C. Food web. Number 8. Why is the relationship between corals and algae in the coral reefs considered mutualistic? A. Corals benefit in the interaction and not the algae. B. Corals receive oxygen from algae and the algae get protection from corals. C. The corals receive oxygen from algae while the algae are harmed. Or letter D. The corals and algae live together without harming each other. The correct answer is letter B. The corals receive oxygen from algae and the algae get protection from the corals. Number 9. What kind of interaction is shown when animals like crabs and mollusks help break down plant litter in a mangrove ecosystem through grazing? A. Competition, B. Commensalism, or letter D. Mutualism. The answer is letter D. Mutualism. Number 10. Why is producer important in an ecosystem? A. It is a source of food to the consumers. B. It is an organism that eats plants. C. It breaks down organism into smaller particles. Or letter D. It is a series of feeding relationship. The correct answer is letter A. It is a source of food to the consumer. What's your score? I know you've got a very good score for the assessment you took last week. Good job! This time class, we will discuss the last topic for quarter 2 in Science 6. The protection and conservation of ecosystem. This is your module 7. Last na lang tani nga topic para sa ato ang second grading period. Yes, because next week, mag-summative test na lang ta sa inyuhang module 6 o ka module 7. Again, this is the last topic for quarter 2 in science. Before we start, let us answer first the what I know part of your module. And this could be found on page 2. No need to write your answer. Dili na isulat ang imuhang answer sa imuhang papel. Ayaw na. Isulti na lang imong answer, mamati ka, and then magsabat-sabat mo kadra sa imong balay kung sa imong answer para at least may retention pod sa imuhang mind sa correct answer in each item. Number 1. Which statement best describes conservation? A. Use of natural resources, B. Maintaining the life of ecosystem, C. Wise use and preservation of resources, or letter D. Utilizing of Earth's resources. Sige ko no. Unsa ang imong answer sa number 1? Isulti lang. Ayaw na isulat kay kapuyon ra ka, no? Kinahanglan mamati lang, no, sa ato ang discussion. And then mag-participate po. Number 1, the answer is letter C. Conservation refers to the wise use and preservation of our natural resources. 2. Which human activity contributes to the destruction of forests? A. Reforestation, B, deforestation. C, protecting the forest against harmful activities. Or letter D, all of the above. Diindira ang makaguba sa forest. The correct answer is? What is your answer first? Result yung sa'yo sa answer nimo sa number 2. Tapos na? The correct answer is? Letter B, deforestation. Ang pagpabutol o kahoy. Ang makaguba sa mga kagubatan or forest. Number 3. The following are ways to conserve Earth's resources. Which one is not? A. Proper waste disposal. B. Reduce air and water pollution. C. Byproducts made from animals. Letter D. Help raise funds for environmental conservation. The correct answer is? Letter C. Byproducts made from animals. Because if you support that, you're also supporting of killing more animals for making products. So that is not the right thing to do. Number 4. Which of the following destroys coral reefs? A. Building man-made fish sanctuaries. B. Dynamite fishing. C. Waste dumping. Or letter D. Both B and C. Dindira makakuba sa coral reefs. Letter B. Both B and C. The dynamite fishing and waste dumping. Paglabay o basurahan o paggamit o dinamita o mangisda. Number 5. Ecosystem is an environment where both living and non-living things exist and blend with one another. A. Disagree. B. Interact. C. Compete. Or letter D. Disconnected. Answer is? Interact. Now, ecosystem is an environment where both living and non-living things exist and interact with one another. 6. Which is a cause of habitat destruction? A. Too many plants. B. Thriving animals. C. Great weather. Or letter D. Pollution. Diindira ang makaguba sa mga puloy-anan sa ato ang mga wildlife animals. The answer is? Pollution. Pollution. 7. Species that are in danger of going extinct are called A. Endangered. B. Threatened. C. Fossilized. Letter D. Adopted. The correct answer is? Letter A. Endangered. Which situation does not maintain biodiversity? A. Growing plants on a farm. B. Protecting all the species in an ecosystem. C. Protecting the habitats in an ecosystem. Or letter D. Removing an important predator from the ecosystem. The answer is? Letter D. Removing an important predator from ecosystem. System. Mahalag predator pa na siya class, mahalag animals pa na siya that eat from other animals, but then that predator is still important. Just like the snake. The snake will just eat live animals just like rats. But then, because of the predator plays an important part in the ecosystem in maintaining balance in our ecosystem. When we cut down trees, what do we do to the habitats of many living things? A. Help. B. Destroy. C. Build. Or letter D, plant. The correct answer is, we destroy. Now, if we cut down trees, we destroy the habitat of the living things. Ginakwaan na itong puyanan ang atuang mga animals. Kumamutol taong kahoy. Number 10. What is R, the way ways to restore denuded forest? A. Reforestation. B. Deforestation. C. Kaingin system. Or letter D, dynamite fishing. Answer is letter A, reforestation. Reforestation is a process wherein we plant trees. We plant more trees. So that's reforestation. Now, what's your score, class? It's okay. It's just a pretest. Now, we will discuss everything that we mentioned earlier as we go along with our module. Now, forests, corals, and mangroves are the types of ecosystem that we mentioned last week, right? And this ecosystem need to be protected and conserved because these are habitats also of our wildlife, animals, and other organisms. We need to give importance to this habitat or ecosystem because they provide our needs. Okay? Now, do you want to know how to conserve this ecosystem? How to preserve this ecosystem? Today, we will explain the need to protect and conserve tropical rainforest, coral reefs, and mangrove swamp. But before that, let us answer first the what's in part of the module. that could be found on page 4. Now, direction. Write PC if the following statement shows protecting and conserving the tropical rainforest, coral reefs, and mangrove swamps. And write N if not. PC and N. PC preserve and conserve or N not. It does not show protecting and conserving tropical rainforest, coral reefs, and mangrove swamp. Let's have number 1. Planting trees in the forest. PC or N? Isulti lang to bag. Ayaw na isulat. Okay? Okay, the answer is PC. It shows protection and conservation of our ecosystem. Number 2. Striking or touching a coral reefs. Answer is no. Hindi dapat sa paghilamtan. That's the home of our marine organisms. Number 3. Helping organizations dedicated in protecting and conserving natural resources. PC or N? Of course, that's PC. No? We have to help organizations that support in preserving our ecosystem. Number 4. Saying no to deforestation. Dili ka musugot pamutlon ang mga kahoy. Yes, that's PC. Number 5. Establishing park for recreation. PC or N? No. You have to prioritize ecosystem, the natural ecosystem, over creating a park. Number 6. Maintaining sustainable limits in logging. Limitahan lang nato ang pagpamutol og kahoy. The answer is PC. Next, participating in local coastal cleanups. The answer is PC. Recycling and disposing trash properly. Of course, that's PC. Number 9. Clearing mangroves for property development. Pamutlon na nimo ang mga mangroves kay gusto ka magpatukod og balay or mga pagpatukod og mga subdivision or mga resort. And answer is N. The last is restoring mangrove forest. Answer is, of course, that's PC. Okay, so at least as of this time, you have now the idea how to protect our ecosystem. Let's have the what's new part of the module that could be found on page 5. Now we will identify what type of ecosystem that I'll be showing you. Okay, so number 1, what type of ecosystem is this? Obviously, that's coral reefs. Number 2, that one. That's, yes, tropical rainforest. This one is, obviously, that's correct, mangrove swamp. As we all know, class, the ecosystem is an environment where both living and non-living things exist and interact with one another. So, examples of these are, of course, as seen here on screen, the tropical rainforest. It's an example of an ecosystem. And of course, that's coral reef ecosystem. And we have the mangrove swamp ecosystem. A tropical rainforest is simply an area where tall, mostly evergreen trees grow and with high amounts of rainfall. And the coral reefs, serve as habitat of many marine animals. They are breeding grounds of marine life. Diri gapag panaghan ang matuang mga isda. Okay? They are composed of non-living components, such as water, air, and soil, and of course, sand. And also, of course, coral reefs composed of living components like fish, like the turtles, the pawikan, the crustaceans, the mollusks, and cnidarians, And of course, we have sponges also and ichnoderms in this type of ecosystem. And we have also the mangrove swamp, ecosystem, which is composed mostly of mangrove plants. And we have animals also living in here, like crustaceans, and the migratory birds. Diri po nisla gapuyo. And then, it is an important system that allows for breeding of fishes and survival of other marine animals. Not only the coral reefs would be a habitat, or a breeding ground of our fishes. and also in this area in the mangroves ecosystem. Diri sila kapag padaghan, no? Before mukadto sa open sea ato ang mga fish, no? Nga mga gagmay, pwede sila diri sa mangrove swamp magtiner samtang gagmay pa lang ang mga fish. It is also an important coastal marine ecosystem. We mentioned last week, no, that mangroves ecosystem is very important, especially in preventing soil erosion or preventing big waves, no. We all know that these ecosystems are very important, but sad to say, today class, tropical rainforests, no, the coral reefs, and the mangrove swamps are disappearing already. Because of man's activity. Most of human activities destroy this ecosystem. These ecosystems are gradually disappearing, no, in the face of the globe. No, despite of growing international concerns, daghan ang kaayong mga resolutions, campaigns, no, conducted internationally, but then these are continuing to be destroyed. And these destructions have a global impact through species extinction and the loss of important ecosystem. Tungod sa mga nangaguba na ninyo klase ng mga ecosystem, nangajutay na po dito ang mga marine organisms or mga wildlife animals because the wildlife animals have no home already. This destruction have a global impact, as I said, to this species and of course the resources as a whole. However, these destructions can be slowed and stopped, no? And in some cases, even reversed. Pwede pa tani siya mahingagaw o conserve or preserve para dili siya ma-totally destroyed class. Paano ka ha? We need to protect and conserve the Earth's resources. We need to give high value to our ecosystem like tropical rainforests, coral reefs, and mangrove swamp, no? Before it's too late. Before it will be totally destructed. Now, what do you think, no, could be simple ways in protecting this ecosystem? Paano kahani mo ikaw? Ikaw pangutanon, paano ni mo mapangalagaan ang atong kalikasan, atong mga ecosystem? Let me tell you some ways, no, to protect and conserve our natural resources. Number one, habitat restoration. We have to restore, we have to preserve the habitat of our wild and marine ecosystem. Atong pangalagaan class, no, dili ta mag, just like sa atong coral reefs. Pangpadali mangod ng uban sa mga isda class, di na sila mogamit og pukot. Ilang ginagamit? Dinamita, no, para usa ka sabog sa dinamita, daghan dayong maglutaw nga mga isda. Pero nganong dili man na siya pwede dapat umbrahon? Once there is explosion, there tendency that the coral reefs, no, which serve as habitat of our animals could be destructed. Yeah, class, years biya ang atong isipon para na pod mga buhi na pud na ang mga corals na nasa ilawom sa dagat. Na, di ba? So, wala na istihan ang katong pong mga isda, mga matay pud katong mga gagmay nga mga isda, usa ka kadbuto sa dinamita ang mga gagmay nga isda nga di magyapon pwede pa kanon, mga matay na. Imbis mauto dapat ang musunod sa mga isda nga mga dagko na pwede kuhaon para sa after na pud nila nga pila ka buwan, pila ka adlaw na ay i-harvest kay para dili mahutdan og resources no nga kuhaan every day. Pero kay ginahimo sa tao usa ka dinamita, patay gagmay nga isda madalahig ang coral reefs mga guba. Ah, so pila tinuig ang atong isipon para lang mabuhi og usab ang mga coral reefs para mapurma usab ang mga coral reefs. Okay? So habitat restoration. Next is reforestation or replanting of forest. Simply sa pagtanong class, no? Makatabang na ka sa pag-preserve sa ito ang ecosystem. Number 3, mangrove rehabilitation. So ito mga government, no, gahatag dyan ang dako ng importansya ani. So daghan kayong mga tree planting activities, mangrove planting activities, no, that really would help preserve our marine and our mangroves ecosystem. And of course, wildlife conservation, which includes protecting a sanctuary where animals live. No, kanang tertiary class, kay dili ra na sa Pilipinas makita. No? Kung imuha ng pamatsyon ang mga forest, mga trees din na, kung diin sila gapuyo, of course, mga matay po ni sila. Na? So we have to conserve the habitat of this, the sanctuary where animals like this live. No? Para dili sila mangjutay, dili sila ma-extinct. Okay? And replanting of trees is one of these. No? Na makatabang sa ilaha, preserve their habitat. And of course, supporting projects of the government and non-government organization that protect tropical rainforest, coral reefs, and mangrove swamp. Kung naay mga programs sa atong government relating to this, no, we have to support. No, we have to support. Ang simple ganing sa paglabay o sa basura nga malata or dili malata, no, the biodegradable and the non-biodegradable could be of help also because kung dili tani siya i-segregate, kita nga manggihapon mag-sakripisyo kay kining mga plastic mubara ni siya sa ato ang mga kanal. Nagtawa, di ba? Dali ra kayo ang baha. Basta daghan kayo masupon sa mga kanal. So, dapat ato ni siyang ihiwalay para at least kabaluta, mabutang ang kining mga basura sa right place. Next, joining organizations that conduct educational campaigns and give information on how to protect and conserve our ecosystem. Na. So, kung na may chance, ha, we can join this organization, no? Just like ganis sa Central School, no? We have Yes O Club. Ang Yes O Club sila ning organization sa kung diin sila ang gapangalaga sa school environment, no? Sila po ning gapanguna sa mga tree planting activities katong napatay face to face nga klase, no? Answer the what's more part of your module. This could be found on page 7. So again, do not write anymore your answer. Let us answer it orally. Number 1, give at least 2 ways on how to protect and conserve living organisms found in the tropical rainforest, coral reefs, and mangrove swamp. Sa katong gimension to ganina, duha lang ang imuhang isabat. The possible answers are supporting projects of the government and non-government organization that protect tropical rainforest, coral reefs, and mangrove swamps. And also, joining organizations that conduct educational campaigns and give information on how to protect and conserve our ecosystem. So these are the possible answers for this activity. Let's have number 2. Number 2, explain why we need to protect, no, and conserve the following tropical rainforests, coral reefs, and mangrove swamps of the Philippines. Why do we need to protect tropical rainforests? Nanu dapat man protektahan ang tropical rainforest ecosystem. We need the rainforest to produce oxygen, no, and clean the atmosphere to help us breathe. So makatabang ni ato mga forest, no, to produce oxygen because we get oxygen from plants. No, so ang daghan kay nga mga ma-produce na oxygen dira dyan sa mga rainforest, right? So rainforests are natural air filters. Sila po ang kuha sa mga hugaw ng mga gas or hangin. Just like carbon dioxide because forests need carbon dioxide because plants need carbon dioxide to produce their own food. So sila ang ga-filter, sila ang ga-kuha sa mga carbon dioxide which are considered air pollutants, right? They store and filter excess carbon and other pollutants from the atmosphere and then release oxygen through photosynthesis. So, gamito nilang carbon dioxide, ang soil, ang sunlight, para maubrag pagkaon, and at the same time, the byproduct of this is oxygen. So, ang ginabalik nila, ani, pagka-ubra nilang pagkaon, is ang oxygen. So, ang oxygen, kinangulan sa mga animals, right? Next, why do we need to protect coral reefs? Anong kinanglan man to protektahan ng coral reefs? Why? Because coral reefs protect the shoreline and coastal communities from impact of big waves. And then, storms, hurricanes as they make landfall. So, dako kayong tabang sa coral reefs sa pag-protekta sa mga dagko kayo ng mga balud. Especially during storms, no? Mga bagyo. And then coral reef supports the entire marine food chains. Dira ni gapanguha ang mga pagkaon ang atong mga marine organism which depend on them survival. Dira sila ang mga gagmay na itong mga isda, dira na gastay sa coral reefs, dira na sila kapagpadagko, dira na sila kapagpagkaon. That's why we need coral reefs. Next, we have the mangrove swamp. Why do we need to protect and conserve mangrove swamp? Because mangrove swamp trap sediment flowing down the river and off the land. So again, this helps stabilizes the coastline and prevents erosion from waves and storms. So dako kay tabang ang mangrove sa kung diin, sila ang protector nato against big waves. Have the what I have learned part. This could be found still on page 7. Let us fill in the blank. I have learned that tropical rainforests, coral reefs, and mangrove swamps are some examples of blank. Hence, they should be protected and conserved. There are some ways to protect and conserve our ecosystem like habitat restoration, blank, 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 and wildlife conservation. So, dagandaghanin na. Unahan natong number 1. Examples. Forests, coral reefs, and mangroves are examples of? Yes, that's example of ecosystem. So, dili na punta sa ikaduhang blanco. So, of course, we have here reforestation, supporting government projects, joining educational campaign, and mangrove rehabilitation. So, again, let us all read together. I have learned that tropical rainforests, coral reefs, and mangrove swamps are some examples of ecosystem. Hence, they should be protected and conserved. There are some ways to protect and conserve our ecosystem like habitat restoration, reforestation, supporting government projects, joining educational campaign, mangrove rehabilitation, and wildlife conservation. The What I Can Do part of your module, and this could be found on page 8. Provide at least 3 major threats to tropical forest. Unsa ang pwede mga rason nga madigil-dilikaduhan ang ato ang tropical rainforest? Tulo lang. Deforestation, di ba? Pamamutulog kahoy. Illegal logging. Pwede mo mamutulog kahoy pero kinanglan may mga permit ka. So illegal logging is one that could be a threat to tropical rainforest. And of course, drought. Ang kanang matinding, init. Wala na ulan-ulan. So, di ba delikaduhan, makamatay unya ang ato mga tanong sa forest. Number 2, mangrove forests have been classified by many governments and industrial alike as wastelands or useless swamps. Do you agree with that? Why? Useless daw ang ato ang mangrove forest. Of course, no, di ba? Mangrove swamps are important because they protect the shorelines from damaging storms, waves, and Number 3, the coral reefs around the world face threats from climate change, overfishing, and pollution. As grade 6 pupil, how can you help protect or lessen the threats for the coral reefs? Paano nimo maprotektahan ang coral reefs? Sayo brown nimo as grade 6 pupil. This could be a possible answer by not throwing garbage that can pollute the water and can harm the simple sa paglabay sa basura, no? Teka nang basura ang kinalabay na to sa kanal, dito mo na mo ato sa dagat. No? Padung mo na dito. So, ibutang na to sa saktong sudlanan, basurahan ng ato mga basura, okay? As simple as that, you could protect our coral reefs. Now, if you do all these things, class, if you support this clean-up drive, planting activities, what value are you showing? Yes, very good. You are protecting and conserving the ecosystem. I hope you will continue doing all of this, not that could protect and conserve our ecosystem. Okay, this time, let us have your assessment. So, karon, magsuwat na jud ka. Now, please get 1/4 sheet of paper for your assessment. For those who have module, this could be found on page 8. again, please get 1/4 sheet of paper. Dira na to kang answer, okay? I will give you 5 minutes to finish your assessment, okay? Are you ready? Direction, write only the letter of your answer. Is that understood? Okay, very good. Your time starts now. Okay, this time class, please get your notebook. Copy your answer in your assessment in your notebook para sunod semana na kay basihan sa pag-check na to, because your 1/4 will not be returned to you, no? So at least kabalo copy lang imong score for your assessment. So please get your notebook and copy your answers now. A reminder class, what to submit for week 7 for this week? Of course, your compilation for your invertebrate animals and your 1/4 in your assessment for week 7. Okay? So remember this, ang imong 1/4 ng imong gyansiran sa atong assessment sa week 7 o ang imuhang performance task about the invertebrate animals which will be compiled in a short size folder. So, mo nang i-submit karon nga Friday. Please copy this in your notebook. No, we will have our summative test next week. Ato ang 4th summative test next week. So, ato ang module 6 ug ang module 7 mauna atong coverage. Ato ang test next week. So, please copy these important notes for you to study for the next week. A summative test. Do it now. Please get your notebook and copy this. Do it now. Okay, so please copy also the pointers for your 4th summative test about ecosystem, the tropical rainforest, coral reefs, and mangrove swamps, and of course, the protection and conservation of ecosystem. Okay, do it now. Okay, kung gusto ninyo class, malantaw ang mga past na ito nga videos, even ang present na ito nga mga video lessons, kadto lang mo sa www.conservingcom.ph. ECES.info. This is our official website for Escalante Central Elementary School. Okay? Now that I menu bar sa babaw, pwede nyo na maklik, no? Ang mga videos na to from kindergarten to grade 6. Okay? And also, please be reminded to please tune in to our Radyo Atraca every day for our radio-based instructions. And also, please do watch our TV-based instruction, Channel IBC. Okay? But if you missed the episodes, you can watch it at YouTube. Okay? Subscribe DepEd TV on YouTube. Okay? To keep updated for all the video lessons of our TV-based instructions. Okay? If you have questions also, class, you can contact me during our offline and online kamustahan that is scheduled every Wednesday, 2:30 to 3:30 in the afternoon. Okay? So please do contact me on our scheduled date and time. In case class na medyo magka-diferensya itong USB, di siya ma-play, hindi po kaka-access sa itong website, sa YouTube channel nako, pwede ni mo siya malantaw ang mga science video lessons. Okay? The past and present na to nga mga lessons, no? Naradatanan sa akong YouTube channel. Tutorial by SiRymon. If you want, you can subscribe to my channel para, biskan di na ni mo siya i-search, automatic, na siya diradayon sa imuhang YouTube na search engine. No? So, please do subscribe my channel to keep updated on my video lessons. Okay, thank you so much class for participating, and that's all for this week. See you all again next week. Have a blessed week ahead. And always remember this, stay home and be safe always. Go forth, rise and shine to